So hello and welcome to another vision channel session about our AI-based machine vision system IDS NXT. Today we are taking a closer look at the new intelligent camera hardware IDS NXT Malibu. In other words, what does it bring new and for what can it be used? A few words to the session before. If you have any questions during or after it, just post it in the chat or the Q&A module. Then we try to answer everything after the session or pass it to our colleagues if necessary. Yeah, so let's get started. Artificial intelligence has changed the landscape of machine vision. As our understanding grows of how industrial processes can be supported by AI-based machine vision, more and more potential opportunities are emerging to use this tool in many different fields: medicine, retail, farming, or in the public sector. And with these new target groups and sectors arise new requirements, other processes that are very different from the industrial process. And this requires manufacturers to adapt their products and services to offer solutions for these new sectors. We are aware of the increasing interactivity, not only in the industrial manufacturing, but also in all these non-industrial sectors and business areas. They may need less precise synchronization of connected systems, but they still require the ability to generate and deliver results quickly. So, with the latest intelligent embedded vision platform of the IDS NXT device family, the Malibu model, we as a manufacturer have exactly that in mind: live streaming of real-time images overlaid with image analysis results will enhance applications such as cashless shops, damage prevention, or assistance systems. Nevertheless, the new platform is of course also suitable for industrial applications such as analyzing tool wear, monitoring chemical reactions, and AI-assisted visual inspections to ensure a high level of safety and quality. Before we talk about the details, let's first clarify what kind of applications we have in mind with the new platform IDS NXT Malibu. For this purpose, we will pay special attention to applications where and how human tasks can be supported. Integrating machine learning into waste sorting facilities can help make the process more efficient and economical, especially in factories where there is still a lot of human labor at work. AI-based analysts paired with industrial automation can reduce errors, improve sorting accuracy, increase productivity, and at the same time reduce the workload of the humans. Especially the diversity of materials on an unsorted conveyor belt is tailor-made for the use of machine learning methods such as classification and object detection. In the medical technology sector too, the intelligent algorithms can play an important role in various aspects of medical imaging and diagnostics, whether in the detection of diseases at a very early stage of by identifying tiny anomalies or patterns in medical images, or by classifying images of organic cell tissue into predefined regions to visually support medical interventions, or to automate logging of samples in medical studies in order to accelerate processing of large amount of data to reduce the workload of the medical staff. More and more automation by robots or self-driving transport vehicles makes coordinated collaboration between humans and machines extremely important. Here, intelligent cameras can help track work processes and walkways and support with visual and acoustic alerts and warnings. And to protect personal rights, these inspections can run on anonymized image data. AI vision can also help to make agricultural tasks more efficient and sustainable in the field of smart farming. In addition to early detection of pests or diseases, or by optimizing the harvest timing, by monitoring the maturity of crops, it can even help to identify and protect wild animals from agricultural machines by preventing collisions. All these processes have one thing in common. They do not require a predefined timing of the image analysis. In other words, there are no special events at which an image must be captured or and analyzed with the minimum possible latency in order to produce a result. The image acquisition of the vision system does not have to be synchronized with the machine. Instead, the vision system monitors the application scene continuously as seamlessly as possible and only reacts when a predefined sign or feature is detected. Then a defined action could be triggered as quickly as possible. For example, here, to stop the farming machine immediately when an animal is detected and a collision could be avoided. Seamlessly is the key word, because here too, of course, every image taken by the camera is analyzed in the background and evaluated by the machine learning algorithms. And here too, the frame rate is a system relevant feature. However, the device components involved in the process, image acquisition and image analysis, work optimally independently, which can be very important for the performance of a small vision system, embedded vision system. But why is the new Malibu hardware a good choice for such requirements, especially when compared to other industrial grade AI enabled cameras? With regard to the suitability of an application, it is of course always important to take a closer look at the requirements, especially when embedded technology comes into play. It is a matter of executing a specific task as efficiently as possible in terms of costs, energy consumption, but also speed and integration capability. That's why the new Malibu hardware reflects a special area of application that we can serve on the other side much more efficiently and thus with much better performance using special hardware. Yeah, the heart of the new platform is an SoC from the chip manufacturer Ambarella, which is already being used successfully in the consumer market to perform the key functions such as AI-based image analysis, video overlays wrapped in compressed video streams very efficiently and all at once and with a huge amount of independence and performance. An integrated ISP provides hardware accelerated image pre-processing, and a quad-core ARM CPU enables a very smooth handling of the camera operating system. So the new Malibu hardware is much more efficiently designed for this specific type of applications when it comes to continuous monitoring and visual support for humans. Also, the use of consumer technology in industrial hardware is neither unusual or new to IDS. With the appropriate software tools of the IDS NXT ecosystem, we create an embedded vision system that can be individually configured for machine vision and AI beginners. Let's take a closer look at Malibu's USPs that make it so special. Due to the Ambarella SoC, the performance is high enough to perform image processing at live speed. In other words, the inference rate can be so fast when training the neural networks in IDS NXT Lighthouse that 25 images per second can be evaluated without any problem, which is already considered fluid for the human eyes. And this provides the basis for the camera's other USPs. The SoC allows the compression of the image data with H.264 or Motion JPEG and makes it available in configurable RTSP streams in the network. RTSP is widely used and can be handled by many mobile devices with no need for a special software, and does of course also with smartphones and tablets via Wi-Fi. A perfect image quality is also ensured by many image enhancing auto features that are executed hardware accelerated in the signal processor of the SoC without slowing down the performance of the platform. To give you an idea of what the new Malibu platform is capable of, I've prepared a small demo for a simple use case. I have here noodles and such metal rings that I mix with the noodles as foreign objects. And with this I simulate the filling of containers with an inspection for foreign objects at the same time. The camera looks from above into the container to be inspected while I fill in the noodle mixture. And let's take a look at how this simple application is implemented with IDS NXT Malibu. For the training of the CNN, images of the different situations of the filling process are needed. These are then imported into the AI Vision Studio, IDS NXT Lighthouse, where the data sets are created in a project consisting of images with the appropriate labels. This is the most time-consuming part of the task. And then I configure the training and start the fully automatic process. Once this is complete, you receive not only a detailed training result with evaluating options, but also a finished CNN that can simply be loaded into the camera's object detection vision app with the cockpit tool. And then the whole thing is up and running. So I've now prepared the demo. I have here two bins, one empty that I can put under the camera. See the camera stand with the Malibu on it, looking into the empty bin, and see the live image behind me. And I have here a smaller bin with the noodles inside, with the noodle mixture, with also the metal rings. And what we do now is to fill in the noodles in the other container, in the other bin. And you can see also the rings are falling into the bin. And what we want to detect now is that the rings is waste into the noodle mixture, and the camera should mark them as a foreign object. Yeah? What we can do for this is we go into the cockpit now. Here we go to the Vision App Manager. Enable the pre-installed Object Detector Vision App and open it. Here I only select my already uploaded noodle waste detector network. We can now see the inference results from the running network under the image. To visualize the results, we can let the camera firmware create a result image where the found rings are marked by rectangles. So you can see that the trained inference works on the camera, and the rings are already detected quite well, even after my short training with only a few images. And we also get a result image with the ROIs of the foreign objects displayed. But as a visual support, the generated result image does not run as live as it needs to. This is because I do not yet fully use the capabilities of the Malibu. To
To improve this, we go into the camera settings again, activate the streaming function for an hardware accelerated overlay drawing, then we copy the RTSP link and use it in a compatible streaming client.
So the video that you can see now behind me comes directly from the Ambarella SoC via RTSP. It's not only analyzed the camera image, but also draws the results directly into the generated RTSP streams. And therefore, the visual support now works much more smoother. So I hope you could pick some insights on our new AI-based camera, IDS NXT Malibu today. The development of this new platform has shown that also AI vision systems are not simply interchangeable and do not simply operate in the same way, especially when it comes to embedded vision. It is important to examine the requirements of an application task very closely. The more precise these are, the more specialized hardware can be used to achieve an optimized solution. And if the right components are already available in the consumer sector, then we also make them suitable for industrial use. The Malibu is a good example of how the best of both worlds can work together optimally in order to be able to use AI vision based image processing in the new emerging applications from many areas. Yeah, that brings me to the end of my presentation. If you still have any questions, just ask them in the chat or put them in the Q&A module of Zoom. Yeah, of course, you can also reach us through our usual channels. Then I will say, have a nice day. Thank you for watching and see you at the next session.